Everybody recite Ya Fizu Ya Salamu today? Yes, Dilipa, did you?
Yes.
Okay, that's good. This is a safety. When we start the class, we have to recite Ya Fizu Ya Salamu always. And I know you guys, all the kids, they know the etiquettes, the sunnahs of eating, right? You know, we should be sit down and eat. Lots of better thing, right hands with the Bismillah Rahman Rahim. I know you guys are masters in so many years. But some things, some etiquettes, some sunnahs of eating, you missed most of the time. Today we wanna talk about the sunnah. These are almost forgotten. First of all, when we eat something, we have to eat with the niyyah, with the intention that we are eating because this is the order of Allah Kareem. Abdullah, did you ever make your mind that I am eating because this is the order of Allah Kareem? Did you ever? No. Because we don't know. We don't know. We just, mom is calling us, oh, there is a food and we are running and we are eating. Now, yeah, from today we have to make a niya. Allah Kareem, my mom make the meals for me and I am eating this because this is an order of Allah Kareem. Allah Kareem grant us this physique. We have to take care of our physique, our health. When we are healthy, we are beneficial for the community. When we are healthy, we can offer our prayers properly. When we are healthy, we can fast. When we are healthy, we can stand up and say our prayer, offers our prayer very nicely. We can stand for a long time. If we're sick, we don't want to stand. We are dizzy, we are weak, we are clumsy, lazy. That's why we are eating. If you make the niyya of the eating, then you will be healthy. Yes, Amna. What kind of niyya we should make when we are eating? Loudly, please. Yeah, and we are eating because this is order of Allah Kareem. This is order of Allah Kareem. That's why we are eating. And the second thing, in this society, this is almost out of practice. And that is, you have to eat together. Daddy is coming, he is having his meal, mommy is eating when she is cooking. Kids are from school, they are eating, and they are having snacks. No, we have to eat together, sit together. Then we have barakah. Ifra, can you sit on the side because Abdullah can't see me? Yes, we have to, sweetie, we have to sit together and eat. This is a source of blessing. That's why we are eating always. Kids are always, mom, you're hungry. Because there's no barakah. There's a sunnah. To sit together, you get barakah. There's one companion of our Prophet, Hazrat Muhammad. Sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam's friend, companion. He came to the Prophet and he asked, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, we have a food, we are eating, but our kids are weak and they are always hungry and they have a craving for the food. And our Prophet replied, you have to sit together and eat. Always, always sit together and eat. Don't eat one by one. Always eat in the Jamaat. Always eat in the... Walaikum Assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Honey, we're talking about some sunnahs. We know the basic sunnahs of eating. That we have to sit down, we have to use our right hand side with the Bismillah. Lots of sunnahs, our kids know that. We have to clean the plate, but lots of sunnah, they are out of practice in these days. We are talking about that. And that sunnah, first thing we talked about, because you are a little late, we talked about that we have to eat with the niyyah. Allah Kareem, we are eating because this is order of Allah Kareem, and this is sunnah. Did we ever thought about? No. We didn't make the niyyah. We said, okay, dinner is ready, let's run and eat. No. First, we have to make mind. Allah Kareem, Allah Kareem, we are eating because this is your order. We are fulfilling your order, your command. And second thing is, we are eating, we want to be healthy and do our duties properly. we can, if we are healthy, we are good in the school. If we are healthy, we are smart. Our IQ level is good. If we are healthy, we are taking care of our physique, then we can stand for a long time and offer a nice prayer. We can fast. If we are weak, we are sick, we cannot do anything for the deen. We cannot help the poor, needy, sick people. That's why Allah Kareem, first of all, niyat. What niyat we have to make? Yes, your name, sweetie?
Rajane.
What niyat we should make when we are eating?
We should always eat with our right hand, and before we're eating, we should say Bismillah.
And we have to make our mind. This is a niyat. We have to make our mind. I am eating because this is order of Allah Kareem. This is the niyat. Right? This is the niyat. You have to eat with the niyat, with the intention. Not without niyat. Yes, Ifra?
So,
loudly, please.
We have to make our mind and eat with the order of Allah Kareem.
MashaAllah, it's order of Allah Kareem. That's why we are eating. We are taking care of our physique. We want to be healthy to help everybody. If we are sick, we cannot help the people. Even other people have to help us. We don't want to be burden on the society. Right? Your name, honey?
Fatima.
What it means that we have to make a niya to eat? Why we are making niya?
So we could thank Allah.
Yes.
So that we're eating and we're like healthy right now.
Yeah, you want to be healthy to help the other people. And the second thing is to eat together. Together on the dastarkhan, on the table. What happened in these days? Daddy is eating separately, mommy is eating separately, kids are having snacks, not sitting together. We have to sit together, then there is a barakat. Our Prophet's companion, he complained that my kids are weak and they are always hungry, feeling craving, they are craving for the food. You guys are saying, "Mom, I'm hungry." You are eating, but you are hungry. Why? Because you don't sit together and eat. When we sit together, there is a blessing, there is a barakat. Then it fills your stomach. It gives you the lots of blessing. And it makes you healthy. And your food digests properly. That's whatever the sunnahs are, we have to follow that. Yes, Abdullah, what we need to do?
We need to sit together.
MashaAllah, we need to sit together and eat. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Why we are washing our hands before and after eating? Yes, please.
No
germs come to the food. We are washing our hands and it creates barakat in the food. When we are washing our hands and it gave us prosperity. It's a hadith of our Prophet, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam, that if a person is washing his hands before eating, Allah Kareem make his eyesight good and Allah Kareem save him or her from the poverty. He will be rich. This is a hadith. And one more place our Prophet said, the person who wants a blessing in his entire home, his family, he need to wash his hand before eating and after eating. I know you guys wash the hand when you eat, you're done. Try your best before and after. This is a wadu of the eating. This is the wadu of the dinner, lunch and the breakfast. Do that wadu. What is the wadu of the eating? Wash your hands before eating and after eating, inshallah. Then Allah Kareem grants you lots of barakat and Allah Kareem gives you, inshallah, prosperity. And you need to clean your fingers when you're done eating with your mouth. Three fingers. Try to eat with the three fingers mostly. If you add the fourth finger, that's fine too. Sometimes you can't handle the food. You use the fourth finger too, that's fine. But the sunnah is with the three fingers, you have to eat rice, roti, bread with your fingers. And when you're done eating, you have to suck your fingers. This is the sunnah. Because the pore of your fingers, they have they have blessing from their toes. When you eat and clean with your tongue, all the blessing goes to your stomach with the saliva. It will help to digest the food. It's easy. No pain, no itchiness in your stomach, and you feel healthy, active, fresh, and light. Not the heaviness, burping. And don't eat too much. Our prophet, Hazrat Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, never eat too much. Make your stomach divide into three portions. One third is with the food, one third is with the water, and leave the one third empty for the air. Because this is like a jug, blender. When you eat, it's blending. And if you fill it with all food, it's suffocated. It's coming up and it gives you the bad burps and it creates the bad smell in the mouth. Our Prophet never eat too much. One third with the food and then rest of a plain water. No soft drink, no juices. We have to follow the sunnah. If we wanna be healthy, fresh, active, try your best to eat on the floor. That's a sunnah too, on the dastarkhan. Our Prophet Hazrat Muhammad always he sit on the ground and he eat it. There were no tables, chairs and forks and knives. I'm not saying that you can refuse to sit on that, but try once a while, ask the mummy, can we have a dastarkhan? And we sit together on the dastarkhan. And our Prophet Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has a leather, red color leather sheet. And I'll try to have one leather sheet at home and eat it on that, inshallah. And sit down and eat. And when there is a food in front of you, always pray to Allah Kareem. Allah Kareem, can you grant this food to me, to my future generation and to the whole ummah, all the human beings and jinns? Allah Kareem, there is lots of people on the earth, on the planet, they don't have even a clean water. And always thankful to Allah Kareem, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, you grant us a food. Can you make this food a physical and spiritual food as well? When we eat this food, Allah Kareem grant us strength in the spirituality. That we can do more zikr, more ibadah, inshallah. And don't just jump to the dining table and the dongas and grabbing the plate. Oh, ma, I am hungry. No. Always wait for the older, that they can start the food. This is a sunnah. Just sit and wait. Because daddy, grandma, they have to take out the food first. Then there is a more barakah. And always recite Bismillah ala barakatillah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. It gives blessing to the food. Even there is less food, you can have a more barakah. And if you forget to say the Bismillah, what you need to say in the middle, if you remember? Yes, please. Bismillahi awalu akhir. You need to remember this dua. Always recite the Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim loudly. Then everybody remember that. Nobody forget. Because if one person forget the dua, shaitan will jump to the food and he has his share. And there is no barakat in the food. That's why try to recite the Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim 7 times loudly. Because there are 7 heavens. You get all the barakah, the 7 heavens in your food. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Bismillah. In this way, when you are reciting, everybody remembers. Mummy is in the kitchen bringing the donga, she remembers, she starts reciting. Everybody is reciting, and this is a thankfulness of Allah Kareem. Allah Kareem, you are Rahman, Rahim, you give us a food. MashaAllah, always try to eat with the right hand. Even if you are left-handed, try to eat food with the right hand. Try your best. And don't grab the food from the other people. Round the corner, you are jumping from the table and you are grabbing and your sleeves are in the donga, dipping in the biryani and nahari. No, sit. And if you need the food from the other corner, what to do? Ask mummy, can you please pass? Don't say that, kebab. When you have a mouth full with the food, don't talk ever. Because you don't know, in front of the mirror, if you stand with the full mouth of the food and you talk, your mouth is so funny, It's hilarious. And I know kids, their mouth is full with the salad, kebab, and they're talking, the food is jumping out on the faces of the other people. No, I'm hungry. No. Keep in your mind, when you have a food, your mouth is full with the food, don't talk. And if you need anything, just nicely ask to your mommy, your elder sister, brother, or daddy, who is near to that plate, a donga, ask them, can I get that, please? Nicely. But when you're done swallowing the food, in the middle, when mouth is full, don't talk. Try your best to well behave and nice. And if you have a different things in your plates, don't fill your plate too much. Don't leave the food in your plate. Don't leave the food in your plate. Always try and ask, okay, let me take a little portion, I will finish that, then add more. I know so many kids, they just have lots of food all together. And they fill, and they have a pile up, they have a mountain. They have a mountain in the plate, and they are keep eating, and a small portion of this food, small portion of kebab, small of biryani, small of salad, and they left the food in the plate. That's a very bad habit. Less food, you can have more if you're hungry, but don't fill it all together. And if you are making the bites of your bread, of your roti, you have to make a small bites, not the bigger one. Even you are hungry, small bites are the sunnah. You have to chew them well. In this way, if you chew your food properly, your stomach need to do less work. And if you are swallowing the one after one, a bigger bites, it creates trouble in your stomach. And you will be sick, sitting in the washroom, bothering the mummy, having the device, tablets, syrups, going to the emergency. This is not fair. You have to make a small bite. And if some food fell on the table or on the dastarkhan, what you do? You have to quickly pick up that thing and then eat it quickly. Because within the 3 seconds, if the bite is on the floor, on the table, you can pick it up, say Bismillah Rahman Rahim and eat it. That's clean. There's no germs even. It's a 3 second rule. And this is a sunnah. Don't leave any food particle on the table. If you are collecting the small bites of the food, a rice, a salad on the dasturkhan, on the table, it gives you barakah. It makes you healthy. It makes your future generations well behaved. Because this is a sunnah. And this is the key of the smartness. Your IQ level will raise if you are collecting the food from the dasturkhan. Don't leave the food over there. And don't eat from the middle of the plate. You are having the food in the donga, in the bowl, in the middle. No, there's a barakah in the middle. Always take food in front of you, even from the dish. And try your best if you have a roti. Usually in our brown families, in our Indian Pakistani families, we have rotis, right? Our kids like that. And when there is a roti in the plate, you have to respect the roti. Don't clean your hands with the roti. Your hands are filled with the curry and you are cleaning with the roti. No. Take the cleanings. Take the paper towel. This is disrespect to the roti. That you are cleaning your hands with the roti. Our Prophet said, respect to the roti. Do the ikram of the roti. And there is another thing. The kids are having the roti from the middle and they left the corners. There's a ring. From the middle they took it and there's a ring. Outside, no. It's disrespect of the roti. You have to eat from the one end to the other end properly. And don't do that you have a roti in the plate and you put the curry bowl on the roti. That's the disrespect of the roti. Don't put a bowl on the roti. No, on the side. Fold the roti on the side of the plate and put the bowl of just salan or shorba or whatever on the side. Don't put anything on the top of the roti. This is disrespect. You have to pay respect. This is a sunnah. And during eating, you don't need to do something, anything, which creates some kind of yuckiness in the food. Means you are cleaning your nose, or you are burping. Because people are eating, you have to behave yourself. Always try your best. Don't talk too much. It's allowed to talk, but the good things, not a bad slangs during the eating. No. Always a good thing, some sunnah, some hadith, some Quran, some natural talks, not you're talking about the dramas, about the movies. No, no, it's not allowed. And if you are eating, don't look at the other people. Oh my God, he's making the big bite. Oh my God, he's coughing. Oh my God, he's eating two kebabs. No, 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 no. Don't look at the other people. Focus on your plate. I saw so many people. They are looking at everybody's plate. No, this is not allowed. This is not allowed. Because the other person is confused, is disturbed. Let him eat. It might he is hungry, he needs two kebabs, even a three kebabs. Don't look at them. And don't eat too much heated food. Some kids are saying, Ma, it's not heat enough. Can you put it in the microwave for 2 minutes? And then it's burning, boiling, and they are just blowing on them and eating. It's not allowed to smell the food. Bless you. It's not allowed to smell the food. It's not allowed to eat so much hot food. Are you blowing? No. You have to wait to moderate temperature. And then you eat that. Even you like the hot pizza, but you have to wait. When it is eatable, you don't need to smell the food. Keep in your mind, you don't need to blow on the food. That you wanna make it cold and you are blowing on that? No. And don't talk bad about the food. Ma, I don't like bhindi. No, don't talk bad. I don't like keema karele. No. If you don't like it, what is the way of our Prophet, the sunnah of our Prophet? If he likes the food, he eat it. If he don't like, he leave it. But no comments about the food. I know the kids, I know you guys are the good kids, but I know so many kids, they are talking bad about the food. And this is, Allah Kareem don't like it, that I grant you the food. There's lots of people, even on the planet, they don't have a clean water. And we have a food. We are lucky. And don't eat the food when you are lazy and lying down with the takiya, with some sofa or something. You have to sit alert, straight with the back. Straight back. You have to eat with the straight back. In this way, food is going to your stomach directly. If you are laying and you are eating and drinking, it makes you sick. Sometimes it goes to the other hole. There's a two holes. There's a two lines. Like a pipelines. One is for the food, one is for the breathing. If we are lazy, we are laying down half laid on the couch, what happened? The food goes to the other thing and it breaks the respiratory system, block it, and we have a choke, God forbid. That's why straight and then eating. And not allowed too much eating. 1/3 of the stomach. Even you are hungry, leave the food, drink the water. And in this way, inshallah, you will be happy. And clean your plate. No leftovers. Because if there is a leftover in the food, plate is cursing. Allah Kareem, don't give them a risk. They left the food over here and they leave for the licking of the shaitan. Allah Kareem, don't give them food. When you eat, you clean the plate. If there is leftover, you have to put the ups and down plate or some paper towel on the top. And after eating, you have to recite the dua and then clean and wash your hands. This is a wadu of the eating. I saw so many kids. I know it's Saturday, you are little kids, you are sleepy. But no yawning is allowed in Islam. You have to be active. If you are lazy, just put your hands in front of the mouth and close the mouth and always wash the hand when you're done eating. Yes, we're sitting on my right, because our Prophet always taught from the right. First, your name loudly and what you learned today.
My name is Rajane.
Rajane, loudly, please.
Today, I learned about different sunnahs, about how we should eat, and more depth about it. Because before we only learned about just saying Bismillah, eating with your hand. Today, I learned more about why and the science behind it.
MashaAllah, Barakallah, Rajan, you got a good point. Yeah, Rajan said that today, first I know only the sunnah, I know about the sunnahs of the eat, the right hand side, Bismillah, sitting down. Today I learned the depth of eating food. MashaAllah, Barakallah, Fatima.
So today I learned about the sunnahs and I learned about sitting together.
MashaAllah.
And if you follow the sunnahs and it'll be healthy for you.
MashaAllah, Barakallah. Yes, who is next?
Abdullah.
Sorry? Abdullah? Yes, Abdullah.
I learned that when you sit together, your stomachs get firmer, and then I learned different stuff that you gotta do when you eat.
MashaAllah. And who is next? Abdullah, thank you. Who is next?
Aisha,
yes.
I learned that you don't jump to the table, and I learned that you sit together, and when you eat, you sit straight.
MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Aisha learned you should sit straight and eat, and don't jump to the food always, and don't talk when you are eating with the full mouth. MashaAllah, Barakallah. Yes, Hadi, what did you learn today? MashaAllah, eat together, wash your hand after and before eating. Hadi, well done. Yes, Brira, what did you learn today? Anything? MashaAllah, la kuwata. Dua. MashaAllah, dua. Dua, please. Bismillah. Bismillah ala barakat. When you done eating, what is the dua? MashaAllah, barakallah. Ending dua. Alhamdulillah, illazi. Ameen, ameen, summa ameen. Yes, Abdullah, what did you learn today?
I learned that we need to sit together when we eat.
MashaAllah, sit together.
Before we eat, we need to wash our hands.
Wash our hand after eating and before eating. MashaAllah. What else? Yes.
We need to sit straight when we eat.
MashaAllah, sit straight like that. You are sitting straight. Now mommy has to give you food. Abdullah is sitting straight. Good. Very good. Ifraji, what you learned today loudly?
To sit together when we eat because we'll get more barakat. And we need to wash our hands before we eat and after.